High temperature, humidity, and low wind speed are associated with the occurrence of dengue cases. Would you like to use these factors to predict the likelihood of dengue occurrence? There are existing solutions that address the prediction of dengue occurrence using other techniques such as crowdsourcing and using inputs from the public. Current practice of NEA to predict dengue cases and clusters is to track their occurrence and place alerts on areas near the location. This may not be practical as dengue cases had already happened. The problem of dengue in parks is a problem that has to be addressed. The parks may be a potential breeding hotspots because park users may throw trash and clog drains. Stagnant water may also accumulate naturally in certain parts of plants. Our team has created a system which monitors the dengue situation using environmental factors that affect the likelihood of dengue occurrence, such as wind speed and humidity. Our system makes use of geospatial analytics and geo-visualization to provide real-time information about the environment in parks, resulting in better and early decision-making. As you can see here, we make use of proximity analysis to analyze the distance between dengue hotspots and parks. Area with intersecting circles may indicate an increased likelihood in dengue occurrence. Spatial temporal analysis gives an overview of changes in weather and dengue cases over a period of time. Data shown is collected from different data sources and can also include the data collected from the sensors. These data collected can affect the evaporation rate. Geo-visualization shows the concentration of dengue hotspots in Singapore. It also shows the hotspots nearby the parks and the intensity of the occurrence and reported cases.